Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to my beautiful Walker Foundation family across the globe. How are y'all doing today? Listen, today we standing on my father's business. Let's jump into it.
But you should have known it. I wasn't going.
All right, my beautiful Walker Foundation family. So today we will be coming from Philippians chapter 4, verses 17 down to 23. I have a very special teaching today, and this teaching will be on how to build your heavenly account. A lot of people have different controversies about paying tithes, but listen, y'all, paying our tithes is a way to us getting supernatural blessings. It's a way to for us to have cut, not just, that's not the only way, right? But this right here will open up a lot of different doors for you when you pay your tithes into the storehouse of the Lord. So you can find you an awesome Bible study church, and you can actually give to that church if your spirit is led to do so. Now, however, if your spirit or you go to God and he tell you this is not the place, don't give. But however, if God is putting it on your heart to give to your church or to give into a ministry that's helping you and your family, give into that ministry, give into that place. All right. So let's go ahead and start with chapter 4 out of Philippians. All right, y'all. So I have my Bible partner, Miss Bella Stevens, today. Yay! Bella, what you want to say to the people? And what else?
God bless you.
God bless you. All right, y'all. So we will be coming out of Philippians chapter 4, verses 17 down to 23. Okay, so let's go ahead and jump into this thing. Not because I desire a gift, but I desire fruit that may abound to your account. Now, this is God speaking to us. I'm going to reread verses 17. Not because I desire a gift, but I desire fruit that may abound to your account. But I have all and abound. I am full, having received of Epaphroditus the things which were sent from you, an odor of a sweet smell, a sacrifice acceptable, well-pleasing to God. But my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Now unto God our Father be glory forever and ever. Amen. Salute every saint in Christ Jesus. The brethren which are with me greet you. All the saints salute you, chiefly that are of Caesar's household. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. So yeah, guys, so it's important that we pay tithes, which is our 10%. So say like if your check is like $389, right, you're gonna pay $38.90 for that week. Or if your check is for $5,789, you're going to pay $578.90, I believe. So 10% of whatever it is that you make, you want to make sure that you sow that seed. Listen, guys, I have not always done this. I've actually just started to do this, right? And it has just blessed me tremendously. It has helped me in my peace in my household with my kids. All right, you guys. So, and in Philippians 4:19, it says, God shall supply all my needs. So, like, by me giving, he's going to meet me and supply my needs no matter what, right? And in the Bible, it actually says, try me. He says, try me. Try me that if you don't, if you give to my storehouse, into my house, bring meat into my house, see that I won't open up the gates of heaven and pour out blessings, right? All right, so all through scriptures, the covenant of seed time and harvest has proved to be the gateway to a world of supernatural blessings, right? So I'm going to go to Hebrews chapter 6, verses 12. All right, so Hebrews chapter 6, verses 12, y'all. This is strong meat. Okay, so you're going to be able to get those blessings. But God is clear when he talks about this in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 12. Listen up. That ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. So we can't just pay our tithes and be like, okay, yeah, I can just sit back, you know what I'm saying, and, you know, money don't flow into me. No, you got to actually seek God for what your next move is. But you got to seek a move. It's got to be a move. You can't just sit down and wait, right? So that's a blessing that God actually gives us, that, you know, that revelation to not be slothful. And guys, listen, I need help with this too. You know, just last night, I didn't do my chores last night because I felt like, because I had a little cough and a little sniffle, that, you know, I can actually relax. So as moms, we cannot be slothful. That's why it's important that when we go to Proverbs 31, to the Proverbs 31 woman, she is a woman of order. She is a woman who is not slothful. She is a woman that gets it done, and her family praises her for it. Now, I see why. Because if we as moms, if we slip up one time, by me not doing my chores last night, guess what happened? Just because I felt like I was not feeling well, you know, guess what happened? My family was walking around in circles this morning. Everybody was like, oh my God, yeah, we couldn't find the keys. You know what I'm saying? So, as moms, we just can't do it, you know? So we have to pray to God for the strength so that we can be the pulse to the family, so that we can be the heartbeat to the household, right? All right, y'all. So listen, I got a brand new exciting prayer for us today. Here. And my baby, she's copying out of the Bible, which is a blessing. Now, so boom, I got the fire this morning prayers for us to pray for us and for our families in the morning, like as soon as you wake up, right? Okay, morning prayer for your husband and for your children and for yourself. Well, first of all, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I repent for my sins, Lord God. As I decrease, may you increase, Father God, to give the people whatever it is that they need, Lord God. I thank you, Father God, for this message touching people's hearts today. All right. Thank you, Jesus, for waking me up this morning. Lord, wherever I go, may the day favor me. Lord, wherever I go, may the day favor my business. Lord, wherever I go, may the day favor my children. As my children enter into the school ground today, any school shooters, we now break and dismantle their arms in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we come up against every principality that will rise up against them in school today. Today, I command every teacher that has been sent by Satan to leave my children alone in the name of Jesus. Today, I command that my husband, as he is going to work his workplace, may the Spirit of the Lord proceed in him today. May his job favor him today. May the blood of Jesus go ahead of him today. For he cannot be robbed in the name of Jesus. For he cannot be touched in the name of Jesus. I come up against every stray bullet in the name of Jesus. Today, I stand in my authority as his wife. I command that the day favor him. When he comes back from work, may he have a joyous spirit. May he have a happy spirit. Amen. All right. So that was just something to pray for, just to set the tone of our children and our husband's day. But let's come on. Let's get into some more prayer, right? Father God, in the name of Jesus, in your word 11:9, it says, by knowledge the just is delivered. I decree and I declare that the knowledge of you and of how I can possess my inheritance and my possessions come to me this day. I decree and I declare that everybody under the sound of my voice shall become a testimony of the glory of the God of Abraham. For our Lord and Savior said in John 14:12, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. Father, my God, the God of Abraham, I now receive that word and I now call forth that you can use me to do these greater works. Father God, in the name of Jesus, you can use me to do these greater works that my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ says that I will do. I decree and I declare that I now receive understanding. In verses 7 says that if we ask, it shall be given. If we seek, we shall find. If we knock, it shall be opened unto us. I decree and I declare Matthew 7:7 over my life in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare that the spirit of Elijah rests upon me. I decree and I declare that the living God speaks to me in my dreams. I decree and I declare that the living God now reveals his secrets unto me. Amos 3:7. For I am a servant to the God of Abraham. I now advance into my prophetic calling. I decree and I declare, as I was created to lead and designed to dominate, I decree and I declare that I am walking in my God-given destiny. I decree and I declare that I have a godly vision that will catapult me and my family to our promised land. Amen, amen, and amen. Okay, y'all, so listen, I have a bomb affirmation, right? And the reason I gotta come at y'all from this angle is because my phone died. All right, y'all, so let's get into these bomb affirmations, right? Okay, boom. So this is a good one. May deliverance and favor be my portion. 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 Right? May deliverance and favor be my portion. My portion. All right, y'all? So let's get into this one. Fortune is my portion in 2024. 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 All right, you guys. So now we are about to jump in to Supernatural Wealth Transfer by Lanika Sky. And we're gonna do us some supernatural declarations right now. All right, so let me go ahead and read y'all the scripture first. Job 22:28 says, thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. All right, you guys. So these are the affirmations that jumped out at me. Okay, I received supernatural change over my life. My husband received supernatural change over his life. My children now receive supernatural change over their lives. I now receive supernatural revision over my life. My husband now receives supernatural revision over his life. My children now receive supernatural revision over their life. I receive supernatural adequacy in over my life. My husband now receives supernatural adequacy over his life. My children now receive supernatural adequacy over their life. I now receive supernatural opulence over my life. My husband now receives supernatural opulence over his life. My children now receive supernatural opulence over their lives. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And what we're going to do is we're going to confess these over our lives every single day. And we will see these words come to pass. And these things will literally change for you in the natural. I pray that everyone that is under the sound of my voice will walk into these supernatural declarations. These are powerful decrees. The word decree means an official statement that something must happen, right? Okay, so 1 John 5:14 says, and this is the confidence that we have toward him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Yay! What a blessing to know that we have a Father in heaven that hears us. Even if your earthly father don't hear you, even if your earthly mother don't even care about nothing you got to say, guess what? Our Father in heaven loves us and he cares about everything that we got to say. That is such a blessing. God, I love you, Lord, and I love you all too, guys. Listen, I'm gonna jump off of here. Y'all have a blessed and highly favored day. I pray that this teaching helps somebody today. I know that we shifted angles because my phone died and all of that good stuff. But listen, y'all, have a blessed day. Today gonna be a good one. Bye-bye, my friends.
I've been sober. But you should have known it. I wasn't going.